Hello everyone, this is Nirmalendu Nirmal. We'll continue the chapter 2, physical quantities and measurement, and this is the part 13 of this chapter. Today we are going to talk about the measuring temperature. Okay, measuring temperature. In the previous sessions we have learned about that measuring mass, measuring time, etc., measuring length, a lot of things we have learned. So this is the last topic of the chapter, measuring temperature. When we touch an object, we feel hotness or coldness with respect to the warmth of the body. We feel hot or cold because of the what? Temperature difference. Okay, so here what is written, that when we touch an object, we feel its hotness or coldness with respect to warmth of our body. So it depends on the warmth of our body. Okay, that an object appears hot because its temperature is more than our body. Which object appears hot to us? The object whose temperature is more than our body. Okay, whose temperature is more than our body. And anything will appear cold if the temperature of that object is less than the temperature of our body. So it is because of the temperature difference. If the temperature is more than our body, then that will appear hot. And if the temperature is less than our body, okay, if the temperature of an object is less than our body, then that will appear to us as cold. So what is temperature? Actually, temperature is the measure of degree of hotness of a body, hotness or coldness. Okay, what is the temperature? Actually, temperature is the measure of the degree. Here the degree means quantity. Okay, we can say. So actually it is the measure of degree of hotness or coldness, the temperature. So if anybody asks that what is the temperature or defined temperature, then we can say that temperature is the measure of the degree of hotness or coldness of a body. Okay, and we know that every physical quantity has the units. So temperature has also the units, like Kelvin, degree Celsius, degree Fahrenheit, degree Rankine. So like this, and the Kelvin is the SI unit of temperature. Okay, the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. What is the SI unit of temperature? That is Kelvin, and it is represented with the capital K. Okay, it is represented with the capital K. The symbol for Kelvin is capital K. And another units are degree Celsius, and the symbol is like this, and degree Fahrenheit, the symbol is like this, and degree Rankine, and that is like this. Okay, so now we'll know about one scientist here, that which scientist? Fahrenheit. Okay, Fahrenheit, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit, was a Polish-born Dutch-German physicist and maker of the scientific instruments. He made the scientific instruments. Which type of instruments? That we'll know here. He is the best known for inventing the first modern thermometer. Okay, he is known for the what? Invention of the first modern thermometer. Which thermometer we are using? Okay, we use to measure the temperature of our body, or which means the thermometers are used in the laboratory also. Actually, he was the, okay, Daniel Gabriel Fahrenheit was the inventor of the thermometer. So the mercury thermometer, okay, let me read this again. That he is best known for inventing the first modern thermometer, and that is the mercury thermometer, and for developing the Fahrenheit temperature scale. Okay, he just invented the mercury thermometer. Actually, in the thermometer, two substances are used, mercury and alcohol, but generally mercury is used, okay, in the maximum thermometers. Okay, and he developed the temperature scale also in 1714. He developed the temperature scale in 1714, and this temperature scale is used as a standard scale in the scientific purpose. Okay, for the scientific purpose worldwide, in whole the world. So now we'll talk about the thermometer. What is thermometer? Actually, thermometer instrument. Okay, thermometer is an instrument, or we can say that device. And it is used to measure the temperature. All of us aware of these things. Okay, because whenever we feel fever, then we use the thermometer. We must have used. all of you must have used. So it is an instrument or device which is used to measure the temperature. Okay, to measure the temperature, we use a device or instrument which is called the thermometer, and it is made up of a thin, long, and uniform glass tube. You must have seen that the thermometer is made of the glass tube. Okay, it is made up of glass tube, and it is uniform. What is the meaning of uniform? Actually, suppose that this is the thermometer, it will be said uniform when the thickness of the thermometer is same everywhere. It will not be like this, okay, or like this. It means it is uniform in the regular shape. It is so. It is uniform glass tube, and it is long and very thin. Okay, and that tube is known as the capillary tube, which is packed, and it has a bulb at one end containing a liquid, either mercury or alcohol. At one end, it has a what? Bulb. Let me show you the figure of the thermometer. Then you will understand better. Yeah, you can see the thermometer. This is the glass tube. Okay, this is the glass tube, and this is made of, this is known as the bulb. Okay, this is known as the bulb, and in this tube inside, what liquid is filled? Which liquid? Actually, in that mercury or alcohol is filled, but in generally or maximum, in the maximum thermometer, mercury is used. Okay, mercury is used. Now let me come back to the point. Yes, so what we have said, that it has a bulb at one end containing a liquid and either mercury or alcohol, which is used for measuring temperature. And how does it work? That we'll understand now. Keep patience. Mercury is generally used as a thermometer fluid. Okay, means mercury or alcohol, both can be used, but generally mercury is used as a thermometer fluid, which is filled in the thermometer. Thermometer works on the principle that heat energy causes expansion in the solid. We know that when we give the heat to the solid or any object, okay, solid, liquid, or gas, anything, then it expands. On this principle only the thermometer works. What happens then, whenever the mercury gets the heat from our body, then it expands, and because of the expansion, it starts moving in the tube. Okay, let me show you. Yeah, suppose that this is the thermometer, and now suppose the level is here, mercury level is here, and we will touch it. When it comes in the contact of our body or any hot object, then what happens, that the mercury gets the heat, because the bulb is made up of the metal and it is the conductor of the heat, and because of this, the temperature of the body is transferred into the mercury. Mercury gets the heat from our body temperature, from our body it gets the heat, so, and because of that it expands. Okay, it expands, and because of the expansion, it starts moving in the tube. And whenever it start, it stops moving, and whatever the measurement will be there. Suppose that in the beginning it was here, and now at last, after some time, it will go here. Okay, because of the heat, then we say that yeah, this much, the that is the measurement of the temperature of the object or the temperature of our body. So I hope that you understood that how does it work. Okay, it works on the principle that when the object get heat, then it expands. On this principle only the thermometer works. Now, yeah, so thermometer works on the principle that heat energy causes expansion in the solid, liquid, and gases. On coming in the contact with a hot body, mercury in the thermometer expands according to the temperature. It depends upon the temperature. If the temperature is more, then it will expand more. Temperature is less, then it will expand less. So it depends upon the temperature, and according to temperature, it expands sometimes more, sometimes less, and moves up in the capillary tube. And because of the expansion, it moves in the capillary tube inside the thermometer. Now, by reading the marking on the scale corresponding to the mercury level of the thermometer, we can know the temperature. Okay, and reading is also some marking is also there on the thermometer. we can see that 35, 36, like this, the marking is there. Actually, that is the marking for the measurement or measurement of the temperature. Wherever the it will go and it will stop, the then we'll see the level of the mercury and what is the reading there at that level. Actually, that will be the measurement of the temperature. Okay, so after that we'll see the reading. Now, yeah, so here we were. By reading the marking on the scale corresponding to the mercury level of the thermometer, we can know the temperature of the body. After reading, the marking on the scale, we come to know about the temperature of the body. The marking on the thermometer are calibrated in degree Celsius or Fahrenheit usually. Okay, marking is done on the thermometer generally in the degree Celsius or Fahrenheit. In the degree Celsius or in degree Fahrenheit usually. What are the advantages of the thermometer? Mercury is, advantages of using mercury thermometer. Okay, nowadays electronic thermometers are also there. Okay, you must have seen the electronic thermometer which does not have the mercury inside that. That is electronic. So, the work of that thermometer is different. And about the work, on which principle that thermometer, electronic thermometer works, about that you will learn, and it is the topic of the higher class. You learn in the higher class. Okay, so electronic thermometer is also available nowadays. So mercury is easily visible through the glass as it is opaque and shiny. What are the advantages? We are going to learn the advantages of using mercury as a thermometric fluid. Okay, so mercury is easily visible through the glass, as it is opaque and shiny. First advantage there, that it is easily visible through the glass, because it is shiny and opaque. Now second advantage is that mercury does not stick to the glass or wet it, means it is very slippy. If you will touch the mercury, it is very slippy, you can't hold in the hand, it is very very slippy, it does not get stuck in anything. So this is the advantage, that it does not get stuck in the glass and it does not wet the glass. It is very slippy. Mercury can be used over a wide range temperature owing to its low freezing point is this and high freezing point is this. So mercury can be used for the wide range, to measure the wide range of temperature, as mercury, the freezing point of mercury is very less and boiling point is also very high. That's why, because of this freezing points and boiling points, it can be used to measure a very wide range of the temperature. Mercury being a good conductor of heat, mercury is the good conductor of heat, and because of that it quickly absorbs the heat to attain the temperature of the object. And because of that, it is a very good conductor of heat. It absorbs the heat of the object very quickly, very fastly. And it gives the reading. That's why the mercury is used in the thermometer. These are the advantages. And because of these advantages, the mercury is used in the thermometer. And it is used as a thermometric fluid. Fluid means liquid, we can say. So scales of the thermometer, about this we will learn in the next session about the scales. In the next session we will learn about the scales on the thermometer, about these things. And after that we will learn about the types of thermometer, that clinical thermometer that we use to measure the temperature, body temperature, and the laboratory thermometer which is used to measure the hot objects in the laboratory. It is used to measure the temperature of anything in the laboratory. So it is very very different from the clinical thermometer. So about these things we'll learn in the next session. So till that time, all of you, bye, have a nice day.